Hi, this is David Davis from ActualTech Media. We're here at ZeroStack headquarters, and I'm proud to be joined by Mr. Steve Garrison. He's the Vice President of Marketing and Business Development. How you doing, Steve?
Doing great, David. Thanks for stopping by. We appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you. So I wanted to talk to you a little bit about the ZeroStack open application ecosystem. Yeah, I know you have some breaking news, some real exciting stuff. Tell us about it.
Yeah, we're always up to something new here at ZeroStack, David. I'll tell you that right off. But it's a big story. But because we're cloud, we think we're the center of the universe, so there's things above us and below us, you know, kind of like a grilled cheese sandwich, we're the cheese.
I like that.
So, yeah, well, it's not lunch yet, but we're almost hungry here. So, but long story short, people want to come to our platform and use whatever they want. So we've built an app store mentality. We have over 40 application and tool sets in the app store. Just like your smartphone, you go in there, click and go. That template provisions the whole system to just run. So a lot of people are claiming one-click operational behavior. We absolutely do that, and we really follow the thinking of Gene Kim at Puppet. That self-service provisioning is step one to this whole idea of agility and CI/CD frameworks. But below us, the IT team in particular wants to make sure they can leverage assets they already bought, like storage infrastructure and compute infrastructure. We've made a lot of announcements around storage, but as you pointed out, we got some breaking news. We just qualified Nutanix's hardware to now be in our portfolio of qualified platforms, including HP, Dell, and Supermicro.
Wow, wow. So you've got all this open hardware ecosystem that you support and have validated at the at the bottom down there, including Nutanix, which is...
It's a bit new there. It's a little different thinking because that's not what people had expected, I think, when they purchased the hardware. But this is what's funny about it, David. Customers are coming to us and asking, do you work with this infrastructure? They're not going to their channel or the OEM. They're coming to us because I think that's the change in the industry. People want software to define the environment. They want to abstract all that hardware below. So our goal is to make the customer happy. And we think Nutanix should be happy too because they're finding more value for their hardware in that customer's mind as well. So it should be win-win.
Absolutely, and most importantly, the business. It's a win for the business because they can use whatever hardware they would like
at
the, to run the private cloud on, and then they have all these applications they can offer the IT group as well as the developers.
Right.
Excellent. So can you give some examples of some of the applications in the ZeroStack App Store?
Sure, sure. I mean, you know, very simple things like Jenkins and Cassandra are CI/CD tools that are very popular. We also use tools like Puppet and Chef and Ansible. We also have various operating systems like CentOS, Ubuntu. So that kind of just maps out the stack right there. You start with the operating system, you layer on some automation tools, and then you actually bring in the CI/CD pipeline tools. That's a common exercise.
Very nice. So making applications easy for the developers, for the applications groups, and making infrastructure easy for the IT infrastructure.
Right, and making sure you get that old, overused term, return on investment, but people really care, right? These are businesses. They want to eke every penny out of that hardware they can. So our whole goal is to make sure they can.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much for your time
today,
Steve.
Appreciate it.